In this video, we will study about the types of microscope. As in your syllabus, there is only one type of microscope, that is simple microscope. But let me tell you a few more description about the how many types of microscope are there and where are they used. So write down in your notebook if you have types of microscope. The three types of microscope is, first is simple, as this microscope was used for the discovery of the cell, which contains two lens, that is biconvex lens. Second is compound microscope. As it is clear by the name, it is compound, it means it is little complex as compared to simple microscope. Compound microscope is basically used to see the specimens and slides, that is used in the schools and colleges. The microscope that you see in your lab, if you are in a school or college, that is normally compound microscope. Third is electron microscope, that is the latest microscope, and that is only used in the laboratories where the researches are going on. So you can easily classify that research laboratories microscope is electron microscope. So what is the basis of classification of these three type of microscope? So the normal basis is the magnification. Magnification is directly related with the clarity of the image, that is the image clear or is it fine or not fine. The simple microscope does not give the fine image of the specimen or the slides. Then compound microscope is better than the simple microscope, as its magnification power is greater as compared to simple. And the most latest is the electron microscope, that is functioning on the basis of the electron beams, that is the most magnified, or their magnification is higher if we compare. So these are the three types of microscope. In your syllabus is simple microscope, but you should also know that what is compound and electron microscope a little bit. After this, as we are seeing that microscope leads to so many discovery of different type of cells, what is their structure, what is their function, how they are differentiated from various cells like animal cell, plant cells, microorganism cells and pathogen cells. So now we will study about the cell theory. Cell theory was given by the scientists Sladen and Schwann in the year 1838 and 1839. So important is cell theory. As the cell was discovered, the two more scientists whose name is Sladen and Schwann. Always remember, the two scientists for the cell theory is Sladen and Schwann. They both worked together and then they proposed a theory in which there was some points. So mainly you have to learn about the two basic points that was in cell theory. First we should write or learn the name of the scientist, Sladen and Schwann. First, remember the year 1838 and 1839. Next, what are the two points of this theory? The first point is the basic point that you are studying in the starting of the chapter, that cell is the structural and functional unit of life. Cell is the structural and functional unit of life. And the second point is, before learning the second point, learn this statement: omnis cellula e cellula. The meaning of this statement is that all the cells arises from the pre-existing cells. For example, if there is, this is one cell, it will undergo division, it will form two cells. Now this will also undergo division, two cells. Similarly with this, So how many cells? 1, 2, 3, 4. So these cells are originated from the pre-existing. So for these cells, these are the pre-existing, and for these cells, this is the pre-existing cell. So the second theory states that all the cells arises from the pre-existing cells. Okay, so these are the 2 points of cell theory that was given by Sladen and Sean in the year 1838 and 1839. Cell is the structural and functional unit of life, and omni cellulae, cellula means all the cells are arises from the pre-existing cells. After this, we will know that what are the types of cell and what is the basis of their classification in next video. Thank you.